than the trigger from the Glock. So now let's see what I meant with this. The pistol is empty, there's no round in it. I will put the slide back. Now the pistol would be ready to fire, and I will slowly pull the trigger, and as you can see, there is a hard point at this stage, and when I pull the trigger, then I have a smooth point when the firing pin breaks. The trigger reset on the Steyr isn't that good as on the Glocks, because you can't feel when the trigger reset is reached. When I pull the slide back and then I let the trigger forward, now the trigger would be reset. And as you could hear and see, it wasn't easy to recognize that. Same thing, the gun is empty, it's not loaded. I pull the slide back. Now the gun is ready to shoot. I push the trigger, and here it begins to be hard. Also hard, 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 hard. And now the trigger shot the gun. The point when it goes back isn't that clear as on the Steyr, but as I told in my comments, this isn't very necessary for this kind of pistols, because they are not for sport shooting, they are for self-defense. But there's the possibility to tune the trigger on the Glock especially, and then you get a closer point. And now let's see the reset. When I pull the slide back, let it forward, and then the trigger goes forward again, and you could hear the click. This click is the Glock trigger reset, and you don't have to let him go forward again, just like on the Steyr, and now you can shoot again. So once again, the trigger reset. You can feel it and you can hear it on the Glock. And that's a big advantage against the Steyr trigger. The Glock has a trigger safety. There is this small part, and it is on the frame. And when you don't pull it back, the small part can't go up and you won't be able to pull the trigger back. So there's also a safety of the firing pin in the Glock. It's called the firing pin safety. It is this bolt here. And when this bolt isn't pushed in, the firing pin can't move forward. When you push the bolt in, firing pin can move forward. At the trigger mechanism, this is made by this part here. When it goes back, it pulls the bolt down and the firing pin would be able to go forward, but the firing pin is held by this plate. As you see, normally this plate is up and it holds the firing pin. When you release the trigger, so this is how it looks normally. When you pull the trigger, this goes back and then down. And the thing who causes that this plate can go down is this little part here. As you can see, it can't go down because there is polymer and you're not able to put this down. When it goes back, there is more space in the polymer and the plate can go down. The repeat action is, because of the slide, when you see this humper here, it goes on the connector. When the slide goes forward again, it puts pressure on the connector, and this will cause that the firing pins, the trigger spring, puts pressure on it and pulls it back, and then the plate goes up. And when the trigger goes forward again, because of the movement of the slide, goes forward, and the firing pin takes the plate, and so the trigger mechanism with him, and the trigger is reset again. Very simple system, but if you have to invent it, I wouldn't know if I had these ideas like a stone clock had. So now let's have a closer look inside of the Steyr. The Steyr has a safety. You can key the pistol with this key. I think the safety isn't a really good safety, because if somebody wants to shoot with the pistol, he's able to unlock the safety with a screwdriver. And so I don't like this kind of safety. To field strip the Steyr pistol, you have to pull the safety in and go with this part forward. And as you saw, the slide comes forward, and you can take the grip off. To get the trigger mechanism out, because you can't see, when you just look at this, you can't see what happens inside when you pull the trigger, so you have to take it out. There is a mark here, and you put this part just close to the mark, and then you can take it out. Now you can take out the trigger mechanism and the trigger housing. Therefore, you have to put this down again. Just go to the half and be careful, because there's a spring inside. Put the finger here. And now you have the safety in your hands. And on the other side, there's also a spring. So put your thumb here. It's, as you see, it's here. And here is the trigger mechanism housing connected with the frame. And when you pull it out, you have a spring here. The spring is for the slide catch. And give it away, because there's a high chance to lose this spring if you don't be careful. So let's see what happens inside. Here we have the firing pin. When the slide goes forward again, the firing pin has a spring inside. And as you can see, the firing pin always wants to go forward. So the firing pin pushes pressure on this plate, especially here. When I pull the trigger, you see there is nothing happen. But if the firing pin pushes pressure on here, I simulated it with my finger, put a bit of pressure in here, then the mechanism takes the plate backwards, and the pressure of the pin will make the plate going downward, and so the firing pin is released and will fire the round when you pull the trigger. Very tricky part, and I think the mechanism on Glock isn't that complicated, but does the same thing. And what I'm missing at the Steyr is the firing pin safety. At Glock, it is a bolt here, which always looks that the firing pin can't move forward. Only if you put the trigger, it will go forward. Let's simulate it with the slide on it. So I will push the trigger mechanism forward, and you see here the firing pin, and it will go back with the plates I've shown you before. Now it goes the firing pin goes back with the plate. Now the gun is ready to shoot. There's pressure on this plate because when I pull the trigger now, it will take the plate backwards. The plate goes down, the firing pin shoots the round, and the gun repeats itself because of the pressure of the round. Slide will go back, and then it go forward again, takes the firing pin with him, firing pin pressure takes the trigger mechanism with him, and there are also springs who reset the trigger. And when I pull the trigger back, plate goes backward, firing pin goes forward, pistol shoots, and the same thing starts again. I didn't make a video yet to reassemble the Steyr pistol, so I will do this in this video. Therefore, you have to put this spring back again. It's the spring for the slide catch. Put it in like this. Then take the slide catch, go between spring and trigger mechanism frame, pull it up, and it will hold. But be careful, it doesn't hold really good. It's easy comes out again, so just be careful with this spring. Then put the trigger mechanism housing back in the frame. First on the back. And then you have the safety to put in. Be careful, there's also a spring. Just push it in a way how it is at the moment. And when everything is fitted, then go in to the frame. As you can see, everything's perfect. Then take the key for the safety and just take the safety in the right position and then take the bolt. Go in, and you also have to see the mark, push pressure on it, and it's in again. You can remove the spring and the barrel like this. It's just like on a Glock. Put it together again, push the spring again in, and now you can complete assemble to Steyr M9A1. Now it's reassembled again. I think assembling is a bit trickier than on a Glock. The system is also more complicated, and the big advantage, as I told you in my last video, is the grip on this pistol. It fits very well, but I still prefer Glocks. And I hope you enjoyed the video. See you next time. Bye bye.